Good morning, dear students. Welcome back to your English online class. Students, today we are going to start with the new book that you are having a supplementary reader, which is It So Happened, right? So we are going to start with the first chapter of this book, which is How the Camel Got His Hump. Okay, so we are going to start with this chapter today. Okay, and this, this story, it is written by Rudyard Kipling. Okay, so students, this is a very interesting story. You'll definitely enjoy it. But for that, you have to watch the video carefully. But before that, let's just quickly know about the author, Rudyard Kipling. Joseph Rudyard Kipling was born on 30th of December, 1865. He was an English journalist, short story writer, right? He was a journalist, short story writer. He was a poet and a novelist. He was a poet and a novelist, right? And he was born in India, and his works of fiction. Now, what do we mean by fiction? Fiction means the stories which are not real. Okay, wo stories jo real nahi hoti hai. Okay, so his works of fiction include the Jungle Book. You all might have gone through the book, famous Jungle Book, and many short stories also he has written, like including The Man Who Would Be King. Okay, so this is a short introduction of the author Rudyard Kipling, Joseph Rudyard Kipling. Okay, so students, this is how we can see that he was a novelist as well as a poet and a short story writer and an English journalist. Okay. Students, let us see the theme of this story. Okay, so what is there in this story? So actually, it's a humorous story of how a camel got his hump, as the title only suggests, right? So you all might have observed that camels have a hump. Hump is like swelled part which they have, at their back. Swelled part hota hai. That is hump. Okay, so how did the camel, got his hump? Okay, so in the chapter, in this lesson, author brings the theme of laziness effectively. The theme is of laziness, right? And the main idea that author wants to convey through this chapter is to make the readers understand the importance of hard work, right? That importance, the why hard work is important. Okay, it's very important to work hard in our life. That is what is the main idea that the author is conveying through this chapter to all of us. Right, so we'll see how how the camel got his hump. Okay, so I'll explain you the story with the help of a PPT students. So watch it carefully and you'll definitely enjoy it. Read the chapter thoroughly, students. You'll definitely get the idea of how actually the camel got his hump. Okay, so let's start with the video. So students, let us start with the story, How the Camel Got His Hump. Now just see, the world had just begun and the animals were working for humans. So this story is of the time when the world had just begun and the animals were working for humans, right? So animals jo the wo humans ke liye work karte the. There was one lazy animal that did nothing and said nothing but humph. Right, so there was only one lazy animal that did nothing. So which was the lazy animal? Camel, right? He did nothing, wo koi work nahi karte the, he did nothing and said nothing but humph, right? He said nothing other than humph, right? Even the clever jinn was at his wit's end. That means, what do we mean by jinn? I hope you know, jinn is like, a spirit that has some strange powers. Now you have jinn, right? You have number of pronunciation for this word, right? So it is jinn. Okay, even the clever jinn was at his wit's end. It means that even the jinn, he couldn't understand that what he should do. Jinn was at his wit's end. That means he was also annoyed and he didn't know what to do for this lazy animal. Okay, now let's start the story. In the beginning, when the world was new and the animals were just beginning to work for man, there was a camel and he lived in the middle of a howling desert because he did not want to work. Okay, so in the beginning when the world was new, animals had just started working for humans. There was a camel and he lived in the middle of the desert, right? He lived in the middle of a howling desert. Okay, howling desert means
Howling is basically making sound. Okay, so here in the desert, number of sounds, were there as number of animals were there. Okay, we'll see in this chapter that number of animals were there in this desert. Okay, so he used to sit in the middle of the desert and he did not want to work. Okay, उन्हें कोई work नहीं करना था. He ate sticks, thorns and prickles, and when anybody spoke to him, he said humph, just humph and no more. Okay, so he used to eat sticks, thorns and prickles. Prickles are, you know, sharp points which are there at the, in the plants and all. Sharp points jo hote hain. Okay, so he used to eat all of this. And if anybody spoke anything to him, agar koi bhi kuch bhi bolta tha unse, he just used to say humph. Okay, nothing else. Presently, the horse came to him on Monday morning with a saddle on his back and said, camel, oh camel, come out and trot like the rest of us. Okay, so here, one day, a horse came to him with a saddle. What is saddle? Saddle is, you know, the leather seat that is there, at the back of a horse on which a person or horse rider sits. Okay, which is leather ki seat hoti hai. Okay, that is saddle. Saddle, right? So a horse came to him with a saddle and he, the horse said that camel or camel, come out. That means let's do some work. Okay, so just come out and let's, just trot like the rest of us. Trot means let's work. Okay, just work like others are working. Okay, and what was the reply given by the camel? Humph, said the camel, and the horse went away and told the man. Now, the reply given was humph. So, the horse went away and he told everything to the man. Now, what happened next? Who came? Presently, the dog came to him with a stick in his mouth and said, so now who was next? Who came to him? A dog, right? A dog came to him with a stick in his mouth and he said, camel, oh camel, come and fetch and carry like rest of us. So the dog came and he said, come and fetch. What is fetch? Fetching is like, you must have seen now when you play with dogs, what do? You throw a ball, right? Anywhere you just throw the ball and dog just catches the ball or find out the ball and come back to you with the ball. Aisa hota hai whenever you throw a ball. It's like playing with the dog. Okay, you just throw the ball and the dog will just fetch it. Okay, just, bring it back to you. So that is fetching. Okay, so the dog said, camel, oh camel, come and fetch and carry like rest of us. That means the dog also said that camel, just come and just help us. Okay, let's do some work. So again, the reply was same. Humph, said the camel. And the dog went away and told the man. So again, the same reply was given. So what happened? The dog went away. Dog chala gaya. Dog went away. And he told the man. Right? He told everything to the man again. Now, presently, who was next now? First of all, a horse came to camel. Then came a dog. And now, who was it? It was the ox. Presently, the ox came to him with a yoke on his back. Now, what is, yoke on his neck? What is yoke? Yoke is like, it's like a wooden, piece of wood that is fixed on the, neck of ox. While it is used for plowing the fields. As it is shown in the picture now, it's a wooden piece that is placed on the neck of ox while it is plowing. Okay, so it came with that yoke on his neck and said, camel, oh camel, come and plow like rest of us. Okay, so, ox came and said that camel, oh camel, come and plow like rest of us. Jaise, rest of us means the others, like others are doing, you should also just come and plow. Okay, so it was like, just come and help all of us. So again, humph, said the camel, and ox went away and told the man. Again, the same reply was given. So he just went away. The ox just went away and told everything to man. At the end of the day, the man called the horse and the dog and the ox together and said, Tree, oh tree, I'm very sorry for you, but that humph thing in the desert can't work. Or he would have been here by now. So I'm going to leave him alone and you must work double time to make up for it. Now what happened? Now, the man called all three of them. Who? Who three? dog, horse and the ox. Okay, and he said that I'm so sorry, you three of you, because that hump thing, that means that camel, cannot walk. Okay, can't walk. Okay, otherwise he would have been here. Okay, otherwise वो यहाँ पे होता and he would have been working, but he's not doing so. That means he can't walk. So what you have to do? All three of you have to work double, right? You have to work double to make up for it. Make up for it means, that means you have to do the work of the camel also, right? All three of you have to do the work of the camel also. Okay, now what happened? That made the three very angry. Okay, so when the man told them that they have to work, that all three of them have to work double due to the camel, right? As camel wasn't working, so they had to work double. So all three of them got angry. Okay, and they held a panchayat on the edge of the desert. Edge means corner of the desert. They had held a panchayat, sort of discussion, sort of, right? And the camel came chewing cud and laughed at them. Now, what was, you know, camel came there and he was chewing cud. Now, what is cud? You know, you all must have seen camels and cows and all. They have, bring out the food that is there in the stomach. Okay, whenever they are sitting, whenever they feel hungry, what do? They just have that ability to bring out the food that is there in the stomach again to their mouth, and they begin eating it. Okay, so they have that ability. So it is known as cud. Okay, the food that they bring out from the stomach again to their mouth to eat it. Okay, so the camel came there cudding food, you know, chewing cud, and he started laughing. And then he said humph and went away again. Again he said humph and went away. Okay. Presently, there came along the jinn who was in charge of all deserts, rolling in a cloud of dust. So suddenly what happened? Who came? Jinn, right? And who was jinn? Jinn was in charge of all the deserts. He was the in charge of all the deserts, right? So he just came rolling in a cloud of dust. Now, you all must have seen, whenever a jinn comes, kya hota hai? It just comes in a roll of dust. Okay, so it's just cloud of dust. He just rolled out in a cloud of dust and he just came there. Now what happened? Just see. Jinn of all deserts, said the horse, is it right for anyone to be idle? So as soon as the jinn came, the horse said that jinn of all desert, is it right for anyone to be idle? Kya ye sahi hai? If anyone is just idle, idle is not working at all. Is it right कि ऐसा सही है अगर कोई work ना करे बिल्कुल भी? So certainly not, said the jinn. What was the reply given by the jinn? Certainly not. He said, no, it's not right. Well, said the horse, there's a thing in the middle of your desert with a long neck and long legs, and he hasn't done a stroke of work since Monday morning. He won't trot. So the horse complained about camel, right? So here this one with long neck, long legs, that means he's talking about camel here. So he said that there is a thing in the middle of the in this desert, he doesn't work, he hasn't done a stroke of work. Stroke is just not a single work, okay, since Monday morning. He won't trot. Trot is like not even, you know, moving forward. Wo hilta bhi nahi hai, right? It just doesn't move even forward to do any work. So what was the reaction of the jinn? Whew, said the jinn, whistling, that's my camel. What does he say about it? So the jinn said, that's my camel, and what does he say about it? Okay, so why doesn't he work? So he says humph and he won't plow, said the ox. Ox also said, you know, that he just says humph and he doesn't even plow. Very good, said the jinn. I'll hump him if you will kindly wait a minute. So he said that, could you just wait for a minute? I'll just hump him. You know, hump him here means I'll just deal with him. Okay, I'll just deal with him, or I'll just, talk to him. Let me see what can be done. Okay, so he said that, let me just talk to him. I'll deal with him. I'll handle him. Okay, the jinn said that I'll handle him. So this is how, all three of the animals complained about the camel to the jinn, who was in charge of all the desert, and they complained that he
didn't work at all since Monday morning, and he didn't he didn't even trot. Okay,
so students, we are going to stop here, and I'll continue the next part in our next video lesson. Till then, just read the chapter, students. See you all in your next class.
Take care, kids.